and this tutorial will cover everything you need to know about the recalibration station. If you have any questions after watching this video, feel free to leave them in the comments section and I'll do my best to respond. To unlock the recalibration station, you'll need to recruit Emma Richards. To do that, you'll need to upgrade the campus settlement to level 3 by completing story missions. Once you unlock the recalibration station, you'll find it in the base of operations, right next to the crafting station. The main purpose of the recalibration station is to adjust attributes and talents on your weapons and armor. This is accomplished by taking an attribute or talent from one weapon or gear piece and moving it to another. The item you're taking an attribute or talent from is destroyed in the process. Recalibrating weapons and gear becomes more important in the endgame when you start messing around with crafting your own builds, but it is a good idea to get comfortable with recalibrations before you reach that point. So let's get into the basics of using the recalibration station, and then we'll go over some examples. Recalibrating weapons requires steel, titanium, and money. And recalibrating armor requires ceramics, electronics, and money. The steel, ceramics, and money aren't all that difficult to come by, but the titanium and electronics can be a little more uncommon. You'll naturally collect all these materials from killing enemies, but you can speed up the process by grinding your way through the tunnel systems, opening all the loot containers you come across. So if you ever find yourself in recalibration mode, but you're low on materials, just grind the tunnel systems. Another thing to mention about the recalibration process is that recalibrating can only occur between like items. So let's say you want to change a talent that's on your favorite assault rifle with a talent that's on a shotgun. You won't be able to. You can only swap talents and attributes from one assault rifle to another, or one LMG to another, or one SMG to another. The same goes for gear pieces. You can only swap talents and attributes from one mask to another, or one chest piece to another. One last thing to mention about the recalibration station, as far as the basics go, is you can only change one thing on the item that you want to enhance. This means you'll have to really think about what you want out of your build. If you're going for a skill power build, you'll need 3000 skill power to use the best mods. So you'll want to recalibrate your gear attributes for skill power. Once you reach 3000 skill power, you can start focusing more on recalibrating the talents. If you want an in-depth tutorial on how to make a skill power build, click on the link in the upper right-hand corner of your screen at any time. Alright, let's get into some examples. We'll start with recalibrating a weapon, and then we'll talk about recalibrating gear. So, let's say we want to upgrade this police M4. Near the top, you'll see the word score with a bar below it. The bar shows the maximum gear score that this police M4 can be upgraded to. In this case, 515. In order to get this police M4's gear score up to 515, we would have to be able to improve the 29% health damage attribute to something better. As you can see on the left, all of the high-end assault rifles that I have in my inventory come with the 29% health damage, so there isn't any way to improve this attribute at this time. So let's take a look at some of the talents. The first talent is called Breadbasket, and it requires at least 5 damage attributes to be effective, which is represented by the red circle. This number is the sum of all the damage attributes I currently have equipped from all the gear and gear mods that I'm wearing. I currently have my DPS build equipped, so I have 9 total damage bonus attributes. 1 from my mask, 2 from my backpack, 2 from my chest piece, 2 on my gloves, and there's also 2 on my knee pads. As you may have noticed, there are also yellow battery icons which represent skill attributes like skill power and cooldown, and the blue shield icon represents defense attributes like armor and health. Anyway, I do like the breadbasket talent, so I'm gonna leave that alone. The next talent is plus 20% magazine capacity, which is actually my favorite talent to have on automatic weapons, so I'm gonna leave that alone as well. The third talent is called Wascally, which helps prevent me from becoming ensnared. I doubt I'd get a whole lot of use from this talent, so let's see what I could replace it with. This AUG A3 CQC has the Rooted talent, which is pretty good, so I'm going to select the AUG to transfer the Rooted talent over to my Police M4. You'll see an arrow going from the Rooted talent on the AUG to the Wascally talent on the Police M4, making it clear what I'm about to do. At the bottom, you'll see destroy and transfer stat/talent by holding F. If I wanted to follow through with this recalibration, I would simply hold F for a few seconds. Before we move on to recalibrating gear, I just want to show you that you can only swap talents that are on the same tier. So, Breadbasket is at the top of the Police M4's talent list, and as you can see, I can only swap it out for the top talent on these other assault rifles. The same goes for the plus 20% magazine capacity, which is in the middle tier. It can only be swapped out for the middle tier talents on the other assault rifles. And as you may have guessed, I can only swap out the Wascally talent, which is the third talent on the Police M4, with the third talent on the other assault rifles. Alright, let's move on to recalibrating gear. Let's say I want to upgrade this 511 tactical backpack and max out its gear score. Remember, gear score will only change when you upgrade attributes. It won't change if you recalibrate talents. This backpack comes with a damage attribute, skill attribute, and defense attribute, but let's say we want to upgrade the damage attribute to something better. While browsing for a better stat, you can easily see which attributes are better or worse by looking at the red down arrows or the green up arrows, but you can also look at the 511 tactical backpack's gear score, which will change when going through the different options. We want to max out this backpack, so we're looking for a damage attribute to swap over that will get it to a gear score of 515. This superior backpack would actually do the trick. In this case, the 8% critical hit chance is capped at 7% if we went through with the recalibration. The number is capped because there's a hard limit on gear score, which means there's a hard limit on the total amount of attribute points a piece of gear can have. Which brings me to a quick tip on creating builds. At first glance, a piece of gear with multiple attributes might look more attractive than a piece of gear with just one attribute, but let's say you're going for a tank build and want to get as much armor as possible. You'll be able to put more armor onto a piece of gear with just the defense attribute than a piece of gear that's using up points in other areas like skill power or critical hit damage. So, just something for you to consider. Also, if you want more information about raising your gear score, I've got a video on that as well, so click on the link if you're interested in how to do that. There are so many fine details surrounding the recalibration station that I actually had a hard time figuring out how to present all of this information without it getting too confusing. That being said, you'll learn even more about recalibrating as you experiment and try out different things, but at least now you know enough to get started. Anyway, I hope you found this video useful. If you did, please consider dropping a like on it, and if you like my videos in general, a subscription would be extremely helpful. Thanks for watching, and Godspeed.